quite well there.
Meet me there by noon, he had said. I had seen him that very morning, beaming of prosperity. His body glistened in the sun as he maneuvered between the trees.
Wow. I almost had light of it. Smoke was an ibanyatal. He throws it up, grumbling. Boy, yare always jail small lighter fluid. Ah, I could have jail, you know? But hey, fuck off. How about you have to die our lighter? Hey, son, just start at a girl almost smarter.
It's a beautiful, beautiful event. Here it goes. With intelligence and diligence, the Lynx fans set up a platform. And then we had plenty of youngins wondering what we got for them. So we turned the spotlight on them and gave prominence to an art form that has been neglected, rejected.
I say spoken word is an expression of self. It's letting someone know how you feel. It's your wife being mad at you for coming home late and you having to say something sweet. That is spoken word.
Had a lot of brothers feeling dejected. We made selfless moves and now selfish dudes want us ejected. Out the game. Why? Because we making ourselves a little name. Man, when these jokers can't get me to lose my focus with they hocus pocus, it's all bogus. Lames, man.
So you almost know I'm telling. Check it, Bulla. Check it, I'm prepared, tell. Hey, man, you get it now. You get it, I'm going to start that. Tell me, I'm not start that. Start that shit, what? Son, I'm getting out. Madam, I'm not out.
Either by air, or through direct contact from the drum to the earth through her feet and taking over her whole body.
I was talking about the history of spoken word. We hear rhymes from Tupac, we hear Biggie, we hear all the hip hop legends, and what they do is actually poetry in its expressive form.
After the first one, we had people addicted, feeling like, hey, this is the right one, be like. Had them hollering like, yo, Jaffa then go full for their Leela. It was a tight one. Yep, you Leela.
But at the end of the day, everybody just comes together. So that's a good thing about Gambia.
Astounded I am. I have been about, where were you guys when I was young?
Sara went to primary school. I'm sure you got bullied a lot. I think F can. Yeah, you went to private school. We know, especially the pipeline Kajara people. I mean, we could fight with Marina kids. That was easy, you know? We were weak, but Marina kids, they were weaker, like seriously.
Drew Dan, I was taking some laundry to my cleaners down there. And I cruised by and this guy said to me, hey, mane bro, they won't let them danka some motobi man. I stopped the car, I got out. I took off my cap. I said, Kangawa bro, mune oh, that balal ma.
Even though there ain't a lot of dozens go with it, the deep get acknowledged everywhere they go. Like, oh, Nila. You know what I mean?
Like, nobody does stand-up comedy in the Gambia. Because everybody gets so personal, you know? I mean, I could make jokes about a whole lot of people here. Have you guys seen the Gamsel show on GRTS? You know, the one that they have with those three dudes? I mean, you watch the Afrisub promoters and you see PJ with his swagger and Ronnie Boy doing his thing. And now with Qcell you have Modu S, even though they have that whole, who's orange, who's cheaper.
I just want to complicate, that a little bit. You know, we have Afrisub, Qcell, who owns Orange. There's actually a company called Orange. And I was hoping they would come in, you know? Just come in and just complicate everything, you know?
I was in Venezuela when I heard that thing, and everyone on Facebook, yes, Afrisub is orange, no, Qcell, it was fun. And then I got home and I went all the way to Batau, New Town, and I saw this big billboard, and I saw Qcell equals $2 each in the building. Afrisub equals $3. Who's cheaper?
And when I heard of this occasion, I decided I should come here to see, in reality, what we were doing at Senegambia in terms of technical appraisal, and I am amazed. I love you guys, and I mean, you agree.
I had a little trouble with my boss once, you know, and he called me and he was like, "Dagafuna muno malaregwe, hamnasa papa." He wasn't even talking about me. He was talking about my dad. Umlaidika koi, mawako lumakwa, sufiyo enu demande wa freedom. You know, so it's that kind of thing. We live in that sort of society where everybody kind of knows everybody.